Hey, what's up, guys and gals? My name is Rick9G. Thank you so much for joining me today. We're going to be talking about I Love Lucy, more specifically about the new magazine that just came out celebrating the 70th anniversary. Wow, that's incredible to say of I Love Lucy. Yes, I Love Lucy premiered in 1951, and we are currently in 2021. So the fact that this came out, really excited to go through it. I'm going to go through the entire thing. I won't read it all, but we'll mostly look at the photos, look at some captions and so forth. And I know maybe a lot of you want one of these and don't have it yet. I've got you covered. I have not one, but two extra ones. I'm going to be giving both of these away absolutely free of charge. They're giveaways that I do. If you're new to these, it's very easy to win. There's no money on your part. You don't have to pay anything. I pay for shipping. I've already bought these, so I just got to pick two winners, and I'll send them out to you. You need to watch this entire video to know how you can win. I'm going to provide a code for you, and that code will make you eligible for this giveaway. Just make sure to watch. If you watch the entire video from beginning to end, everything will be explained to you. And yeah, all I ask in return is your support. Your support meaning watching videos, sharing them with your friends and family, and that's about it. With that, it's worth it to me to just give something back to all of you who've been so good to me. So like I said, in this video, I'm gonna go through about half of this, and then I'm gonna do a part two with the other half of it. And yeah, so I'll give one of these away in this video, and in the second video, another one of these. So yeah, without further ado, let's just get right to it. We'll look at this. Again, I'll point out things that are just interesting to me, that are just like popping out at me. And then from there, we will go. So hopefully what pops out at me and what's interesting to me is interesting to you. So there's no real timeline how long this video will be. It'll be as long as it needs to be. So here it is, the Life magazine with Lucy, beautifully colored. We can talk about the accuracy colors maybe at another time, but great. Lucille Ball here, her life, love, and legacy, forward by Deborah Messing. So if you're a fan, go ahead and check that out in here. And We Love Lucy, doesn't say I Love Lucy. And her show, We Love Lucy, was actually the Lucy Desi Comedy Hour. So that kind of works. This is the second apartment that they're in, not the first. That is from season 3 onward, right up until they went to the house in the country. Actually, let's look at the back. This is pretty cool. So this is early on. This is probably the first episode of I Love Lucy. This is my guess. This is probably Lucy thinks Ricky's trying to murder her. This was the first filmed episode of I Love Lucy, so it's interesting to know it's up here. This is, of course, the Italian episode where she's stomping grapes. And this is the ballet episode, I believe. If I make any mistakes, just let me know in the comments down below. I haven't prepared anything, so everything is just spur of the moment, just my knowledge. I really haven't prepared. I've skimmed some of the pictures like this, but that's about it. So I haven't really gone through it. Yeah, so it's about 90 pages, so we'll do 45 in this video, okay? All right, then look at this. You have a lovely, beautiful picture here. Really nice. Look at her beautiful blue eyes. Just beautiful woman in general. All right. So this is cool. I love this. This is, of course, just all the credits here of, you know, who made the magazine and stuff. Table of contents. Let's take a look at what that looks at. Okay. There's a foreword. There's an intro. Unforgettable moments. Wishing Upon a Star, Making It Big in Hollywood, The Odd Couple, Fred and Ethel, Queen of Comedy, We'll Always Remember Lucy, and Perfect Instinct at the helm of Desilu. So it kind of goes through the trajectory, which is really nice. A little caption down here, Lucille Ball, Vivian Vance, and Bill Frawley shooting a scene with Desi Arnaz in an early season of I Love Lucy. So you can tell this is the first apartment. You can tell lights here while they were filming, cameramen, right? The end of the set right here. You can see the line over here. First apartment. Are these the flowers here? I'm trying to figure which one. This is clearly the one where they have a fight. So I'm guessing this is the one where it's no children allowed, where they're fighting because of little Ricky crying. That's my guess. It doesn't really give the episode. And sometimes a lot of these magazines, they get it wrong. There was another one that came out before this. And yeah, and it was completely wrong in what they said. So this is Deborah Messing's article, her foreword about this, and you have her here, right? I haven't really seen Will of Grace or Will and Grace, so I don't know much about it, to be honest with you. I won't pretend like I do. This is, of course, the famous episode, Lucy is Pregnant, or Enceinte. think that's how you say it, 1952, she was actually pregnant here with the real Desi Arnaz Jr. And yeah, very emotional episode, one that if you haven't seen, you definitely should like. Very cool. All right, this talks about just like an intro to Lucy. Look at this beautiful picture. Lovely, lovely, lovely. This is apparently 1960. Now, is that correct? 1960? That does not look right to me. And like I said, I could be wrong, but this is for my years of study. The reason why I don't believe this is 1960s, her hairstyle and just how she looks. She changed her hairstyle pretty much like around the time of her divorce with Desi. That was it, right in 1960. And so you could say, well, that was just right before she changed it. But no, in the Lucy Desi Comedy Hour, she definitely had a different type of haircut and she did look older. This to me is like 53. That's just my guess. I don't even think it's earlier than that. All right, so see, this is, to me, Lucy in the 60s, okay? And yes, this is 64, so this makes more sense. This does not look like 4 years ago. I don't know, that's just me. But yeah, where is this? This is at the New York World's Fair. Wow, August 31st, 1964. And look at that, she has a huge police escort. Look at this, people are really happy to see her. Even little kids, look at this, little kids watching. That's so cool. And there's a lot of stuff up here, like advertising. So it says, through this arch at 10 a.m. will pass the world's most beloved redhead. Wow, Lucille Ball, star of the Lucy Show, here for the gala celebration of Lucy Day. Wow, starting at Hollywood, USA, 10:30 a.m. This is Hollywood. Wow, interesting. Very cool. All right, of course, the famous job switching episode. Everyone knows this episode, right? Yeah. So it talks about job switching, talks about Elvia Allman, who appeared in many episodes of just in general with Lucy. She was the secretary for the Milton Berle episode in the Lucy Desi Comedy Hour. She's also the writer of the, what do you call it? She plays the writer of the one with Tallulah Bankhead, that she writes that play, quote unquote. So yeah, she's in several episodes, but you can't really recognize her because she has an angry kind of disposition here and another one there. She does a good job. Rabbit, squeakish. I love this when she opens the lady's mouth like this. So, so good. Her vagrant, right? He's in a couple episodes of I Love Lucy. He also plays the nephew of Mrs. Trumbull in the washing machine episode where they fight. Yeah, Lucy is envious with Cynthia Harcourt, right? Yeah, very, very cool. And they're on the Empire State. Who remembers that episode? Very cool. So yeah, it's going through a lot of these. I'm guessing these are like maybe like the favorites. I haven't really, let me see. If I read, Rick, you would know. Oh yeah, unforgettable moments. So it's just highlighting some of the moments that I think people remember most, right? The Italian episode, she almost drowned here, where she almost like swallowed enough grapes where she could have choked for real, like not a lie. It was part of the filming. It was just a miscommunication. This woman did not speak English. And it was hard to, basically, she was a professional grape stomper. Lucy wanted authenticity. Yeah, I made a video on that, so you should check it out. Lucy's Italian Movie, Season 5. Now, this is not Elvia Allman, okay? This is another actress that Lucy was really good friends with, actually, in real life, Mary Wicks. And yeah, she did a great duo with her. She was a lot in the Lucy Show, as well as Lucy. Oh man, I'm blanking right now. But in the one with her children, which I can't believe I remember. I'm forgetting right now. But yes, very good. Oh yeah, so when they moved to the country, the little chicks, you have little Ricky, Richard Keith, Ethel, Lucy, Fred, no Ricky here. I love Fred's face. My goodness. Love it. Lucy raises chickens. People love the chicken stuff because there was a lot of episodes on the chickens. The freezer. I do like this episode a lot. You can see a light peeking out over here. I don't know if you can see that. Very cool. I love the icicles that are hanging down on her. If you've ever seen Dumb and Dumber where they're kind of frozen in Colorado because of the weather, it reminds me of this. It's just like, I don't want to say they're ripoffs, but let's just say they're inspirations from I Love Lucy, like this type of makeup, where she gets locked in that freezer, season one. Still season one, probably the most recognized image of Lucy, I would say, is here, and of course back here. This, right? Those are the two things. like the top two things you think of when you think of Lucy, right? Vita, Meta, Vegemin. Made a many videos on this, so don't forget to check that out. Now, this is one that a lot of people don't talk about. I don't think they played on syndication much. It's a good one. Lucy in the Loving Cup. It's a little out there, but I mean, what episode of Lucy isn't out there, right? They're all kind of out there. That's kind of the point. And what I love is these photos share stuff that, like, right, like the line over here, like, look at this, just the creases, things that the camera doesn't pick up, but the photograph does. Lucy in the Loving Cup. I have to make a video on how there were holes right here, how she could see. There's an opening in the back. Just a very cool thing. So this is young Lucy. See, this is young Lucy. Look at her. This is, I'm trying to see when this is. So this is the 40s. This makes sense, right? Wishing upon a star. She came to Hollywood in 33, determined to make it a movie. She was a B-list actress. She worked hard, harder than most actors and any other actress that appeared in scores of films by the 40s. She was a queen of the B-movies, but she wanted much more. Then she became the queen of, comedy, TV. Look at her. There she is. Such a cutie. Look at that. Look at those cheeks. My goodness. Over here, this is cute. She look at that bow right there. Her little legs, her little stubby fingers. So cute. Look at this. This is 6 months. This is 2 years? Wait, excuse me, not 2 years. 6 months. Wait. Yeah, this is, oh my gosh, opposite, about 6 months old, and this is two. Okay, that's what I thought. Like I said, just very extemporaneous. A lot of the stuff I'm seeing for the first time. Yeah, this was appearing in 1933's Roman Scandals. Okay, this is a movie over here. And then opposite top, 4 years later, she landed plum role in Stage Door, bottom right, down over here. This is cool. You can read about when she was born, her early work, right? This looks like her. Remember, Lucy was originally a blonde. Can you guys spot her over here? Well, I mean, come on, right? Let's see. Right there. I mean, look at that face. How can you not tell that's her, right? Absolutely. This is my favorite, like, look of hers. She's just so beautiful here. This is 38. And this is the Phil Baker show. So she's doing skits, music, songs, things like that. Time is going so quickly. Wow, look at this. So this is her in Room Service. Yes, she was in a movie with the Marx Brothers, which is really cool. Here she is. It's not one of the best Marx Brothers films. There are funny moments in it. It's all right. It's all right. You should check it out just to see her in it, to be honest. I think Harpo and Lucy are the two best things of this movie. I mean, don't get me wrong. I love Chico. I love Groucho. But just like the lines, and I enjoyed seeing her on film with them. Okay, here she is over here. All right, with the Marx Brothers, as I mentioned. 2 years later, she played a burlesque star named Bubbles in Dance Girl Dance right here with Louis Hayward and Mary Carlisle. Is that how you say it? Carlisle. Desi Arnaz, of course. Now, this, I believe, is Too Many Girls, is it? Yeah, so this is Too Many Girls. He actually mentions this in the episode of The Mustache. Watch that episode, and there's like an agent, a talent scout, who comes in, and Ricky's trying to show off his resume, and he said, he's showing him a scrapbook, and he says, hey, I was in Too Many Girls, which is a real movie that he was in that he actually met Lucy. So that's like a little Easter egg in there. That's a little nugget that many people don't know. I haven't seen many people talk about. She was a really good dancer, actually. And that is something that many people don't know about. People think she's a horrible dancer. She acted like she was horrible. She's pretty good. This is great. Very central picture right there. All right, 1943, Dewberry Was a Lady, right there. So these are most of her movie career and things that she was in. Siegfried Follies over here. Columbia Pictures, British Censors, right? They're in different beds. Franchot Tone in Her Husband's Affair in this one. Interesting. I've never seen these. So I've only seen the long, long, long trailer. That's the only movie of Lucy's I've seen. And here, getting married, right? That's what that looks like. no captions for us. Let's see what this says. This is a great one here with Desi and Lucy. This is like them meeting, like their engagement and all that. Let's see. Well, I will always remain a bachelor girl. Desi popped the question and they headed straight to Greenwich, Connecticut, where the Justice of the Peace officiated at their wedding at the Byram River Beagle Club. This is mentioned in that marriage license episode in season one. The newlywed soon after bought a cozy 5-acre spread in Chatsworth. Yeah, this is the thing in Chatsworth. Pop the question here. And yeah, this is their little place together. Little. 5 acres. Their doggies, their pool. Desi was a sergeant in the Army. He did serve his country. He, of course, American Army, even though he was a Cuban, he did. He was a staff sergeant, actually. Correction there, not just a sergeant. All right, and this is a premiere for her movie, Dragon Seed. So he was, like, supporting her in her work while he was, you know, working in the military, which is really cool. This is 44. He was on leave. This is cool, and he's already married. Wait, by the way, wedding ring. So they were married at this time. They were actually married in 1940, so this is 4 years into it. Okay, this is the Desi Lu Studios, one of the main lots that they had. They had many lots. Radio gave Lucille Ball more than a medium in which to hone her acting skills and comic timing. Her hit broadcast, My Favorite Husband, sparked the idea that she and Desi Arnaz would later turn into television's I Love Lucy. So this is it. I'm going to read you this last thing before we sign off. Didn't that time go by so fast? Look at this. She's on the little scooter and it says Lucy on it. I mean, look at that. Okay, so this is the time where they founded Desi Lu Production in 1950. 6 years later, paid $6.15 million for the former RKO studio in Hollywood. Back when Lucy was making pictures for RKO in 1935, she earned $50 a week. Now she owned it. That is probably the best caption I've ever read in this so far. This is amazing. Okay, she made $50 a week. We can do the conversion maybe another day, but it gives you an idea. This is the same in terms of value. So this is equivalent, pretty much. Yeah, I guess the difference between 50 and 35, but yeah. $50 a week to $6.15 for the studio that she owned now. It's nuts. So, thank you so much, guys and gals, for this video. I know you want to know how to win this, okay? And I will give you the code, and that is Lucy Magazine. Make sure in the comment below, you need to write Lucy Magazine and whatever comment you'd like. Just put those two words into it. That's your code. Without that, you're not eligible. You also need to be a subscriber, so hit that subscribe button. You only need to subscribe once to my channel, not every time you do a giveaway, okay? Just once, and that's absolutely free, and hit the like button. Those three things must be done. Then, lastly, I need your contact information. This is for everyone who participates. This is the only real fair way that I can verify where the DVD is going and to make it fair for everyone. Then after that, I'll pick a winner and I'll ship it to you free of charge. I'll contact you, of course, if you do win. Make sure to watch the second part, which will be coming out soon. If you watch this way after I put the first part, then the second part should be up. Yeah, well, we'll go through the rest of this. Stay tuned. Thank you so much for the support. Congratulations to the future winner of this. We'll do the next one in the next video. We'll see you next time, guys and gals. Thank you so much for your support. And most importantly, be hopeful. Thank you so much to all the supporters I have on Patreon, especially my diamond tier patrons. Vito L, Tommy G, Ricky, David D, Citizen Kane, Sally N, and Grace U. If you want to find more exclusive content, visit my Patreon page, links in the description.